So promise to yourself that you are going to focus on learning future scenario of the society. Okay. You have to consider that you have to, Madhu, I'm answering your question, that you have to adapt to the changes in the world. So suppose you have done a particular degree and people are learning more and more through online medium or going to upgrade or update their courses. You need to always be updated if you want to get at a position where you are secure. Always stay updated. Just, okay, how to improve my confidence? I am going to share my YouTube channel with you where there are videos where they can help you to improve your confidence and self-esteem. Just 2 to 3 minutes more about the questions. What is the common and important skill for any of your career? I will say communication. Very, 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 very important communication skill. Be a talkative person. Have that capability to talk to any person, communicate with any person, and then you have very high chances to succeed in your career.
Good evening to all present. I'm Richa from Kumaraguru College of Liberal Arts and Science, and I would be moderating today's session. Evolve, it is an initiative of the Class Leadership Council to help the students to develop their skills and knowledge during quarantine. The theme for today is career guidance, and the topic is career choosing right. And we are lucky to have an eminent speaker, Mr. Gurpreet Singh, a certified life coach in counseling skills and nutrition, guided meditation, NLP, and REBT practitioner. I once again welcome you all. Kindly make yourself visible and unmute your audios. You may put your questions in the chat box. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Richa, for inviting me here. And I hope this session has been recorded.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So one request to all members right now. Okay, first is, as Richa told all of you, that you all should be visible here. So I don't just want to be talking to avatars right now. So everyone should be there visible. I should know who is there in this session. Everyone make your video available. Okay. And you can use the chat box continuously. Whatever questions are coming in your mind, you can write. Whatever inputs you want to give, you can give. Whatever questions I ask you, I want you to participate in all those questions. Should we begin the session? So everyone's attention on the PPT, and we begin. I want the moderator to direct me to begin the session.
Sir, you may begin.
Okay. So this will be an interactive session. Okay. So this is not going to be a lecture. So you are here to know how to choose your career. And if you want to do so, you have to interact with me. Only then you will be able to make out what is the right career for you. So whenever I am interacting with you, I want active answers from all of you. If you want to benefit from this session, you have to be very active. Okay. So we start with career. What according to you is career in one sentence? Just answer to me. What do you feel? What is career? Quick. We need to keep the time in track. What is career? Sastika. Okay. The first one to answer, and I really congratulate Sastika for being present and being active in the chat. She says job or profession. Okay, very well defined. So I would say career is an activity. Okay, you do so many activities on a day-to-day basis. Why is this activity different from that activity? Career is an activity which gives you the opportunity to earn money. Okay, every day you do a lot of things, but they don't give you an opportunity to earn money. So career is the activity which gives you opportunity. Okay, Janani is telling me career is a way of enjoying your passion. This is a very good input from Janani. So a career is going to give you money for sure. Okay, but suppose you do not love your job, you do not have passion for your job, okay, you do not enjoy your job, there are chances that you will leave your job, your career in around 5 to 10 years. There are so many people, engineers who are doing a lot of courses, and they quit their courses in the second or third year because they don't love their job. They don't love the course. Some people, they quit their jobs after 2 to 3 months. So if you love your job, if you are passionate about your job, that is your ideal career. Okay. Okay, one more input is career is an individual's journey of learning, work, and other aspects of life. Very good. Any other choosing a career? Okay, on the slideshow, the first slideshow is choosing the career. One of the hardest and most exciting choices you will ever make. Why is this choice a hard choice? Because this is a once in a lifetime decision to make. Once you make this decision, you choose the career, you cannot shift to another career which is going to be taxing for you emotionally. It is going to be taxing for you with respect to your finance, and you are going to waste a lot of time. Okay, choices you will ever make is your career, although chance may play a part unprepared. Some people say they have chosen a career by chance. Okay, and some people, they make a informed decision and informed choice. Okay, so your career should be a decision which you make by choice. Everyone following me? Yes. Type yes.
Yes.
Yeah, be active. Please be active. Okay.
Please be active.
You being active is my only motivation. As I may end up sleeping in the middle of the session. Yes, Y E S. Three keys to type. Okay. Choose a career that is something. Okay. People tell you to choose a career that is something which is going to give you money, which is going to give you fame, which is going to give you prestige. Okay. There are a lot of people, your parents tell you to choose a career which your already cousin is doing, or your friends are doing, or someone in your family has the same profession. But usually you ask your parents this question that you have a complete separate identity. You want to do what you want to do. You want to do what you love to do. And if at all your parents try to forcefully make you choose a career, that is going to be a very big disaster. So I would say choose a career that is something you really like to do. As one of the candidates pointed out, that the passion and love for the work is very much important. Do you agree?
Yes.
Yes. Do your research and choose carefully and thoughtfully. Okay, what research I'll be talking about? Okay, right now you're just after your 10th or 12th or maybe graduation, and I'm telling you to do a certain research. Whenever you want to go swimming, okay, how many of you tried swimming or no swimming? Like me. Who knows swimming? I am clearly audible, and you can always type in chat so that I get a very clear background sound. So suppose you want to... Yes. Okay. See, again I am telling you, I want all of you to be active. Otherwise, I don't enjoy the session. And if I don't enjoy, you don't benefit. So if at all you want to enter a swimming pool and you don't know swimming, you will always know what feet is the swimming pool. Will you be able to survive the height and width of the water? So whenever you choose a career, you will not just straight away jump into that career. You will research that career. Now, what is this research? You need to know what is the curriculum of that particular course. How much do you earn in that career? What are the good things about the career, bad things about the career? How much time do you take to succeed in that career? How much money you need to input to get into that career? This is a research you need to do in order to choose your right career. Agree? Yes, Anjali agrees. Others don't agree. Kirtana agrees. Okay. Okay, make it meaningful to you. Okay, what do you understand by a meaningful career? Okay, everyone wants to go to their job morning, early morning, 9 a.m. They work till 9 p.m. And when they come home, they are so much frustrated by their job, and they come home and then say, I am really fed up of this job. This is not a meaningful career. If you want the career to be meaningful, whenever you work the entire day, whenever you work the entire day, you are not going to feel bored, tired, you are not going to feel lethargic, you are going to feel connected to your work. Ask A.R. Rahman in the middle of the night to create or compose a tune, he will agree. That is called a meaningful career. Ask Lata Mangeshkar to record a song, she will agree. Ask Sachin Tendulkar to give an interview regarding cricket, he will agree. This is called a meaningful career, where you and your career become one. You are not practicing your career, but you are one with your career. Agree? Yes or no? Okay, you owe it to yourself for look for a work which is rewarding and meaningful. Okay, so career is not just going to be rewarding. Okay, suppose if I tell you that I like being a social worker, I like doing social service. I go every day out of my house and I help people, I serve them. Okay, and I like social service. Now, social service is giving me passion. It is giving me inner happiness. It is going to give me that satisfaction from inside. But if it is not paying me, it is not considered as a career. So career has to be a combination of your love, liking, and also your financial aspect. These two things have to combine in order it to be a career. So we talk now about career values. Okay, we talk about career values. I want each of you to tell me what is valuable to you when you choose your career, when you go about choosing your course, when you go about choosing a degree. What is important to you? I'll take names of few career values. Some people want achievement, creativity, helping others, helping society, environment, money, status recognition, free leisure time, leadership, moral fulfillment, intellectual stimulation, stability, security, variety, authority, enjoyment, competition, challenges, independence. What is that career value which you want to be present in your career? Okay, generally says self-satisfaction. Very good. Others also, what career values do you want in your career? Career values, please. To lead my life, okay. Leadership, to never be tired, very good. Enjoyment, it's very important to enjoy what you do. The people who are not writing the career values means they are okay with any kind of job. Maybe they will be happy to serve in McDonald's, right? Challenges, enjoyment, satisfaction, leadership, very good. 70 people, I want replies, what are your career values? If you don't know your career value, then I can't take you in that direction. Yes, stability, challenges, independence, very good. Okay, we proceed. Choose career options that match your values. Okay? Knowing what you value the most, okay? Creativity, very good. So knowing what you value the most will help you make an informed career choice. So one of the career values is helping others. Okay. Now give me an example quickly. Give me an example of one career where the career value is helping others. But it should also include money. Tell me fast. Which career is revolving around helping others? Give me some examples. Yeah, teacher, very good. Chartered accountant, indirectly. Social work, very good. Doctors, very accurate. Nurses, yes, doctor. Very good. Civil servant. Yes, very good. Maybe person working in the fire department. Yes. Banking teacher. Yes. Psychologist. Very good. So here we come to know almost all careers are going to help others in some other way. So even today, if I call my operator for assistance, okay, for my mobile network, there is a person who picks up the call who is an employee for call center. But even that person is being helpful to me in some way. Some careers are directly helpful, some are indirectly. Second is prestige. Some people want to get into IAS just because of the prestige. Third is high income. Who all want high income? Paisa kisko chahiye? Who all want high income? All. Devi Priya knows everyone here. Individual answers, who all want high income, not get high income. Who all want from all of you high income? Earn money. Gokul wants high income. Anuj wants. Okay. Flexible work hours. Who wants flexible work hours? That whenever you want to work, you can work. Whenever you want to rest, you can rest.
Yeah, for
everyone,
the
children. Mute your audio. So you need to establish your career values, career choice and goals for motivation. Okay, there is no substitute to knowing yourself. The more you know yourself in and out, the more the chances that you choose a better career. Next slide, please. Surviving in current competition. What is this competition? Very fast, quickly. One or two people just tell me, what is this competition? What competition are you facing in career? What is this competition we are talking about? Very quickly. Wherever I don't get replies, I don't explain that part. Corporate, vocal, very good. See, this is a give and take seminar. You give me, I give you. What is this current competition? Very fast. Yes, economy very good. Competition means, yes, beat our loss. Education. Okay, so whenever you give your examination of your 10th, 12th graduation, there are hundreds and lakhs of people who give the same examination. So whenever you pass this examination, you get a degree which is similar to all other people. So what special do you have? If the degree is the same, what special do you have? You will always have some control over your career. You must accept risk and plan for the future to advance your career. A college degree does not guarantee employment. Do you agree a college degree does not guarantee employment? Do you agree a college degree does not guarantee employment? Okay, Anjali does not agree, Avantika agrees, Agnes agrees. So whenever you pass an examination, you go to an employer, they ask you so many other things, they do not hire you on the basis of just the degree. The degree is the entry point. It is like your ticket. But even when you get the ticket and you go inside, there is no surety that you are going to get a seat. Agree? So what will give you this guarantee? Okay. One thing that can give you guarantee that you will always be employed, you will always get a job, you will always earn money is that a commitment to lifelong learning will help you keep employable. If you want to earn all your life, you have to learn all your life. Agree? If you want to earn all your life, yes, higher degrees are must. If you want to earn all your life, you have to learn all your life. Greater your marketability. Okay, so whenever you go and you go for a job, you take your resume and you tell that employer that, sir, by me, sir, this is my resume, my name is so and so, I have done this particular degree, these are my skills, I can help you in these matters in your company. So you market yourself and you are like a product which you market your own self. So if you want this product to be taken by employers, you need to do more. You have to learn more. We proceed. So what factors to consider in your career? Okay. First is you have to please mute the audio. And I suppose the people whose audios are not muted, if they could be muted manually, or they could be just removed from the group also, that would be okay. People whose audios are not muted, you can remove them from this session. Yes, yes. Find out people whose audios are not muted. Very good. Okay, so what are the factors to consider when you have to choose your career? First is you have to find out your careers from a lot of different careers. You just don't have to take one career into consideration and start just pursuing that career. If your mother has told you, your father has told you, your siblings have told you, your friends or your relatives have told you, no, you don't have to select the career on their behest. You need to find out a lot of different careers, then choose one career. Second is you have to get involved because this is your life decision and you need to know. Okay, so this is your life decision and you have to go with this decision all your life. So you need to know what career you are choosing and why. Get advice from people in your target occupation. Okay, whenever you people are following me, keep on typing yes, okay, or following you F. Okay, that is also okay. I would like it to be interactive. So you have to take advice from people in your, very good, you have to get advice from people in your target occupation. The people who are already pursuing the careers, they are the best people who can help you. Next is you have to follow your passion. Okay, the passion is the type of career which you are never bored by doing. That is your passion. and there to try something new. You always have to try something new in your career, because once you don't take chances, there are very fewer chance that you might succeed in your career. There are not just four or five careers, maybe architecture, engineering, MBA, MBBS. There are a lot of careers which can help you make great money. What you don't have to do while choosing a career. Yes, very good. Keep it interactive. I like it. Okay, you don't have to just focus on just one career. Second is, you don't have to just choose a career because you seem that this career is cool for you, or people are suggesting this career, or this career is in the boom right now. Or you don't have to allow any person to choose the career for you or push you into a job. And you don't have to assume that you know everything. Even if you assume that you know everything, then also there is a chance of cross-verification, cross-checking, making it doubly sure, because this is once in your lifetime decision and you don't want to regret this decision. Okay, next slide. What is the role of parents? What they can do? Okay, so if there are parents in this group, it is for them. Or if you want to show this to your parents, you can later on show this to them. So parents have to, yes, very good. There is a need for support from parents, right? So parents have to always support their children in whatever avenues they want to do. They have to sit and talk to them. Whatever career they want to follow, they have to know and acknowledge that there are some new careers. Okay, don't follow the trends in the society. Very good. And you don't have to judge your children based on the marks. In Indian society, people judge your intellect, your intelligence, your capability based on your marks. Yes, believe and motivate. So 95% plus people want, okay, this person is for science. 70 to 75%, this person is for commerce. And 45 to 55%, okay, this person is for arts. No, this is not the way. Each and every career is important. Okay, motivation is very important. Each and every career can give you money. A photographer can earn lakhs of rupees in a month if he is an expert in his field. If an engineer who is a substandard engineer, an engineer who is a substandard engineer can be jobless. Do you agree? Okay, very good. Interest. Okay, next slides is, what are the factors which affect your career? First is your interest. We are talking about interest from a very long time. Interest means you love your work. You want to do that work again and again. You are not bored by doing that work again and again. And you don't get tired by doing that work again and again. Second is skills. Okay, suppose if I want to do a particular work, I like that particular work. Very good, everyone. If I like that particular work, but I can't do that work nicely, or I like cooking, I want to go to the kitchen, I want to make food for my wife, for my daughter, I want to cook. And suppose I don't know how to cook. So this is not the right career for me. It has to be a combination of, first is your interest, whatever you like. Second is your skills. Then is aptitudes. Whenever you see your mark sheet, you see your degree, you see your scores of your maths, geography, social sciences, you see physics, then there are economics, you see your scores. That is your aptitude. How good are you at that subject? How much you like that subject? How much passionate you are about that subject? Okay. So suppose you have your interest, number one. Okay. Second is your skills, capability to do work. First is motivation to do work. Second is capability to do work. Third is your aptitude. Okay. Your potential to do work. And then is people skills. What is people skills? Anyone can tell me what is people skills very quickly. Just one or two persons. What is people skills? These are factors which will help you choose your career. Okay. Special powers in them. Maybe like Spider-Man, Superman, behavior, okay, communication, very good, okay, Jacintha, Gracie, okay, does marks and skills in particular area major contribution, okay, to make a career path, okay, see, there is one question coming up, What is the importance of marks? Okay, the marks can actually help you get into a desired college. Okay, if suppose there are certain colleges, maybe there are certain prestigious colleges where you want to enter, then marks can help you. But there are so many people who have passed out of these prestigious colleges, and then even then they are struggling for their job because they did not learn in the while they were in their college years. They did not focus on learning. They just focused on getting the degree. So always your focus should be on learning. Pattern of behavior, behavioral interaction. So people skills very similar to communication. How I communicate with other people, how I talk to other people, how I express to other people. So let's take an example of our current Prime Minister of India. So let's not go into his educational background or qualification, but I will say he surely possesses good communication skills. Agree or don't agree? Yes. Next is experience. Okay. So whatever career you want to choose, you also have to have experience doing that work so that you get used to doing that work. And then family tradition. Some people, suppose there are some girls who want to go for modeling, acting, and their parents would say, no one in our family does modeling and modeling is not a very good job. So sometimes family traditions can also affect your career choice. Then your personality, are you an introvert person, extrovert person? Do you like mingling with people? Do you want to travel outside? Do you want to stay at a desk job? These are your personalities. Then your life goals and work values. Suppose I take an oath that I don't want to ever lie in my life, then there is just one career which I can never choose. Tell me which career. If I lawyer, yes, lawyer, advocate. I agree with this thing. So almost in all careers, you have to be manipulative in some way. But lawyer, I think this is the career where you need to lie on the maximum basis. Okay, next slide. So how do we explore the interest? You can be investigative in nature. You can be artistic in nature, you can be social in nature, you can be enterprising, you can be conventional, you can be realistic. Okay. The slideshow shows exploring your interest and Holland's hexagonal model of career fields. Okay. Teachers are also lying these days. Doctors are also lying. Next is where to go for help. Okay. Suppose you don't know what career you need to choose, where will you go for help? Quickly type, where will you go for help if you don't know how to choose your career? To your mother, father, uncle, auntie. Career guidance, very good, Revati. Parents, counseling, very good. I will ask dad. Okay. Teachers, yes, teachers are also very good expert persons, very good. So first is career counselor. Okay. Now, second is your faculty, as we told teachers, okay, career counselor can help you choose the right career. Second is your faculty can help you. Third is your upper class students, the people who are already passed out. Then there are student organizations, maybe the alumni of your college, there are some organizations where people are already there and they are pursuing some careers. You can have discussions with them. Then placement services can help you. And then there are certain internet resources. There is Quora, there are online forums, there is YouTube. There are so many platforms online where they can help you to get some clarity about your career. All of these platforms will not give you the exact answer, but they will take you nearer to your career choice. They will help you to some extent. Okay. Next is how do you choose your career effectively? First is explore the various careers. Okay. A quick confirmation. Everyone is able to view the presentation, right? Type yes for the presentation if everyone is yes. Okay. So first is explore the various careers. Okay. Everyone has to explore different careers. Okay. Even if you want to have food, you go to an hotel and you want, if you go to an hotel and you order some dish, you will try different dishes and then you will choose what you like. So in case of career also, you have to always research different kinds of careers and then choose one. Okay. Who all from this chat are going to marry in their life? Who are going to marry one day? Very fast. Say marry yes if you want to get married. Okay. Abhisha wants to get married. Okay, no, Mani does not want to get married. Okay. Okay. So we are not going to make matchmaking here, okay? I'm not going to connect the prospective brides and grooms here. Suppose you want to find your life partner, okay? Okay, someone says presentation is not viewable. Please, someone show the presentation. Someone start the presentation. It's very important to view the presentation. Moderator, come in, please.
Yes, sir.
Yes, we'll shortly start the PPT. Again, who all are going to get married? Say marriage, yes. Marriage, yes or no? No. To some point, means maybe a contract marriage, 6 month marriage. Is the presentation viewable? Then just type PP, everyone, PP. Okay. So if you want to get married and your mother and father, okay, arranges a matchmaking for you, and then they take you to a particular place and say, see, this is the girl we have chosen for you, and you need to get married to this girl. Will you marry that girl or guy? Okay, why will you not marry this guy or girl? Because you do not know this person. And why do you don't want to marry a person you don't know? Because you don't have to spend, because you have to spend your entire life with this person. And if you want to spend your entire life with this person, you cannot change your life partner. So you have to be very, very careful in choosing your life partner. That is why you will always talk to that partner, that person again and again, meet that person multiple times, try to know him inside out, try to know his good, his values, his bad, everything, and then you will weigh the pros and cons and then say what is your answer if you want to marry that person or no. So if we compare marriage with career, you say choosing a life partner, okay, I would say the life partner which you are talking about, just take an example of your parents, your mother and father. Tell me how many hours your mother and father are with each other. I want a reply. How many hours are your mother and father with each other? How many hours your mother and father spend with each other? How many hours? No. How much time do your parents spend with each other? 24/7. Maybe, okay. 2 hours, okay. Gokul, okay. Gokul's parents, maybe they are in the same workplace. Okay, 2 to 3 hours, 20, okay, Avasthi's parents are also at the same workplace, 24/6, okay, hardly 2 hours, merely 1 hour, okay. So when you compare life partner, we say the life partner is going to be always there with you at all times. And when we compare this with actual life scenario, and when we go for a job, we hardly meet our life partner, very few times, yeah, 9 hours, maybe that is also sleeping, right, or talking. So whenever you choose your career, you are at your workplace for more than 10 to 12 hours. You go in the morning, you come at night, and then you meet your life partner. I will say your life partner is not your life partner. Your career is your life partner. Do you agree that career is your life partner? Do you agree career is your life partner? Yes, strongly agree. Okay, so if you want to choose such a life partner who is going to be with you all your life, and even when your superficial life partner leaves you, your career is going to be intact with you, providing you the money, the support you need. Do you think it is a very, very important choice to choose your career wisely, even more than choosing your life partner? Life partner versus career, what is more important? Both, okay. Career, both, career, both, okay. So, okay. So, I'm not suggesting anyone not to get married or become a monk. You will get married whenever the time comes. So you have to explore various careers. You have to browse you have to browse the career section of a local bookstore. So at the end of the session, if I get email IDs of all of you people, or maybe a single person, I'm going to share a bonus with all of you. One is, M. Sharda, life partner is more important. Okay, automatically, if we have a good career, we have a life partner. Okay, so going to the bonus after this session, I'm going to share with all of you. One is a PDF file which has all the careers post 10th and 12th, where you can explore every career, knowing each and every time all those careers. One is this PDF, that is the bonus. Second is I'm going to share an audio recording, which is a self-hypnosis guided meditation audio file to help you choose the right career. These are two bonuses for all those people who complete this webinar till the end. And those who exist, it is not for them. Okay, next is, coming to the next slideshow. What to look for in the career. Okay, first is major career field target. Okay, what specialization you want to pursue, that is very important. Second is preferred type of work. What kind of work you want to do? It should be a manual work. You want to do a work where you can research. You want to do where you can think or you can communicate. Or maybe you are into mass media or journalism or indoor or outdoor. Or it is more of a mechanical work, or it is more of a logical and rational thinking work. So type of work. Second is income requirements, very important. How much income you want to earn is very important. Next is geographical requirements. Most of the people quit their courses because they find their courses to be very stressful. Do you think stress is the number one factor for you to give up your career very fast? Is stress the number one factor? Okay, no. Mahalakshmi says no. Okay. Next is level of interaction with other people. How much do you want to interact with people? Is it an indoor job, outdoor job? Amount of independence you want in that job? Okay, it is going to be a 9-to-5 job, or are you going to be on field, or maybe if you are a reporter or a photographer, or maybe a journalist, or maybe you are an actor, or maybe a set designer or an animator? What kind of job you want to do? That is also very important. What are different type of people you can interact with? Physical requirements, benefit perks, good boss training, and reputation of the firm in the industry. Who all here want a good boss? Who all want a good boss? Who all from here wants a good boss? Am I audible to everyone? Moderator, am I audible to everyone, right?
Yes, sir, you are.
Okay. So how do you choose your career? First, it's a good idea to have several careers in your mind rather than just one career. Okay, if you are choosing a career, make sure at least 5 to 6 careers, you have to shortlist those careers, and from that career, you have to do your research and then you have to make a choice. Why you have to do this? Because more than 60% of the students change their majors. More than 60% of the people, they quit in the second or the third year of degree, or they don't want to continue their courses, or they want to quit their jobs. Next is, it is very important to be knowledgeable about different types of careers, and you have to develop different kinds of skills. Apart from your academic skills, you have to develop certain kind of skills which can help you get a job. Is everyone following type F? Is everyone following? If you type F, I'm going to move ahead. Or else I'm going to wait. I'm waiting in the chat box for some replies. moderator.
Yes, sir.
Is everyone active or not active?
Yes, sir. They are replying on the chat.
Okay, I am unable to see any chat. Maybe a technical issue, right?
Yes. I'll check in and let you know. Sir.
Okay. We proceed now.
Yes, sir. You mean?
Yes. One second. Yes. Okay, so we are in the slideshow where it shows assess your skills. So I'm going to tell you what is the accurate way to find your career. This presentation is about you helping yourself. Okay, and whatever guidance you want from me post this session, I'm available for that. But for this session, I'm going to make you self-dependent where you can choose your own career on your own. First is assess your skills. Okay. Now, what are your skills? First is academic strengths. Okay, what do you mean by academic strengths? The kind of marks which you get in your academic scores, in your examinations, in your college or school. It includes your reading, writing, speaking skills, listening skills, mathematics. Yes, exam marks, right? Next is creative thinking. Okay, creative thinking is very important. So that you can think out of the box. Because why? Employers want people who think differently. They do not want same kind of mechanical people who think in the same way. Next is problem solving and decision making. Okay. These are your, yes, strong minded. These are your academic strengths. Okay. Now I'm going to share with you one thing. Suppose your academic strengths are not good. There are a lot of people who do not score good marks, or maybe they do not get very high percentage, or maybe they get passing marks in certain tests. Do you think such people can make be successful in their life, or they cannot be successful because their academic strengths are weak? They can. Okay. So I am going to share with you one secret. Academic strengths is one part. And suppose you do not have good academic strengths. Okay. I'll say you have poor academic strengths. There is one thing which can surpass this. There is one thing which can take you out of this zone. There is one thing which can make you highlight. There is one thing which can make you shine. That is called your personal qualities. Okay. Now, what is your personal qualities? Give me an example of personal qualities. Is personal qualities means how you look? Okay, behavior, how you dress, what is your hair, is that your personal uniqueness? Okay. Communication, very good. Communication skills, very good. Talent, yes. Attitude, character, very good. Very good. So suppose if you have personal qualities, I'm telling you from my experience of last 7 years of counseling students for career on a regular basis, every day 3 to 4 sessions for career in my area, that is Mumbai, and overall in the entire India, approximately 7 to 8 people on an everyday basis for online career counseling. This is my experience, which says that you can surpass every individual which has got good academics if you have personal qualities. So let's share the personal qualities. First is self-esteem. What do you mean by self-esteem? Meaning of self-esteem. Self-management and responsibility. Meaning of self-esteem. First, meaning of self-esteem. How? Yes. How we think about yourself, how much confidence you have, what you think about yourself. Do you believe in your capabilities? Yes. Very good. Knowing about yourself. Yes. Second is self-management. Means suppose you have a problem in your life and you know how to get out of that problem. Problem solving capabilities. Yes, confidence in your own abilities. Self-respect. Then is responsibility. If you take responsibility of your actions. And then there are people skills. We spoke about people skills later on, which is your communication skill. It includes your social skills, how much you act and react with the society. Your negotiation skills, okay? How much you can influence other people. Then is your leadership qualities, how much people follow your decisions, and then is your teamwork. I say again, very clearly listen to me. Very, very clearly listen to me, everyone. Okay? I'm sharing this with you right now. Suppose if you are so in your academic strengths. Okay, you need to improve your academic strengths for sure if you want to get into a college of your dreams, or if you want to pursue a course in the college or an institute of your choice. But suppose if you want to be successful in life, irrespective of your academics, if you really want to be successful in life, this is the mantra from today itself. From today itself, promise to yourself that you are going to develop your personal qualities. From today itself, promise yourself that you are going to develop your personal qualities. From today itself, start working on your self-esteem, your confidence, your presentation skills, your self-management, responsibility skills, your social, negotiation, leadership, teamwork skills. From today, promise this. If you promise this to me, no one is going to in any way put you down. There are no chances of you failing. I promise you this. This is promise from my side, that you will never fail in your life if you have your people skills developed, your personal qualities developed, even if your academics are okay, because everyone is not going to score 95, 98, 90. Okay, so if everyone has the desire to succeed, everyone wants to succeed, they have to develop these skills. Now one more bonus for all of you. Okay, one more bonus for all of you at the end of this session. All of you people, I'm going to share the link of my YouTube channel. You, every one of you, have to subscribe to the channel. On an everyday basis, I keep sharing videos which will help you develop your self-esteem, self-management, responsibility, social, negotiation, leadership, teamwork skills. On an everyday basis, I share videos. Next slide is see a career counselor. Okay, so first of all, we should at all times try on our own to find a career which is suitable for us. But suppose out of all the trial and error, out of all the research, out of all the work we have done in order to find the right career for us, and still we are doubtful, and still we do not know what career is best for us, and still we are confused, because career is a once in a lifetime decision. And suppose if you take this wrong decision and after 2 to 3 years you realize, no, I chose the wrong career, even by planning so much, by doing so much of research, by trying whatever I was told in the seminar, I could not find the right career, then this will be a very bad U-turn for you. So to be doubly sure, what is called doubly sure? Okay, every time you are doubly sure that yes, I want to secure my future, that there are no chances, well, I will do error, there are no chances that I will mistake, there are no chances that I will make a wrong decision. Okay, so to be 100% sure, if you want to be 100% sure, okay, you can even choose your career if you are 90% sure. So it could be sometimes like a trial and error. There are chances you could not. But to be 100% sure, what you have to do is see a career counselor. Either you can see a career counselor who is near to your house at your place, or you can book an online career counseling session with me, with anyone. It does not matter wherever you do your career counseling, it does not matter. Everyone follows the same protocol. But if you want to be doubly sure, 100% sure of what career is best for you, you should go for career counseling. And why? A career counselor is a trained professional who can help you discover your strengths and weaknesses. Okay, first of all, we are aware of some of our strengths and weaknesses. Most of the time, we only know about our weaknesses. Okay, we do not know about our strengths. So a career counselor is going to help you to find out your strengths and weaknesses, hidden potential. Second is, he is going to help you evaluate your careers and goals. Okay, Dr. Rupavati from Nirmala College for Women, I welcome you to this seminar. Okay, so you have, the career counselor is going to help you evaluate your values and goals. So whatever career values we spoke about and whatever goals you have in life, maybe these goals are distorted in your mind. They are very much not clear, and maybe there are a lot of hurdles in your life, in your career goals. So a career counselor is going to help you demystify all of this, get clarity about all of these in a scientific way. Sort through what type of career you want, okay, what kind of career you want, okay, bridge the gap between your needs and your wants and your desires. That is what a career counselor does for you. Now the career counselor is not going to tell you what to do, because your parents are already being telling you what to do, your relatives are already being commanding things to you, your friends are already giving you suggestions. Okay, suppose you really want to know what is your career, a career counselor is going to give you the capability to make your own decision. It is going to give you the capability to make your own decision so that you can make an informed decision. You become capable to select your career in an informed way. It is going to generate awareness inside you. So career counselor is not going to do spoon feeding. It is going to help you to learn cooking. Any questions till now? Yes, 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 yes. We are going to keep the track of the time. There is just 5 minutes left. Very quickly, few questions. Very quickly, few questions. We started late by 10 minutes, but we are just going to consume 5 more minutes. Very quickly questions. Okay, what career shall we select, sir, at present world? Okay, first of all, there is no good career, bad career, or there is a career which is in scope. I am going to share this PDF file with you where you are going to explore a lot of career options. And then when you visit a career counselor or maybe take a session wherever you want to book, this is okay. High benefit, high profit. No, there is no career with high benefit, high profit. If you have the capability, if you have the skills, then any career is going to give you high profit, high money. If you have the skills, a degree or a piece of paper is not going to give you money. The employer is not going to give you money based on a piece of paper or your degree. You need to have skills inside you. If you have skills inside you, you will get paid whatever you want in your life. So that is why, one more promise for all of you, whatever career you choose, whatever degree you choose, you all have to focus on learning the skill, being an expert in the skill. Even if you are a plumber, if you are an electrician, be the best electrician, be the best plumber. So promise to yourself that you are going to focus on learning future scenario of the society. Okay, you have to consider that you have to, Madhu, I'm answering your question, that you have to adapt to the changes in the world. So suppose you have done a particular degree and people are learning more and more through online medium or going to upgrade or update their courses. You need to always be updated if you want to get at a position where you are secure. Always stay updated. Just, okay, how to improve my confidence? I am going to share my YouTube channel with you where there are videos where they can help you to improve your confidence and self-esteem. Just 2 to 3 minutes more about the questions. What is the common and important skill for any of your career? I will say communication. Very, 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 very important communication skill. Be a talkative person. Have that capability to talk to any person, communicate with any person, and then you have very high chances to succeed in your career. Very quickly. Sorry, if a person has no goal and very slowly write. Whenever I tell you to write the question, only then write, because I'm not able to follow. Sir, if a person has no goal and interest, how should we choose a career? Okay, this is where career counseling is going to help you to find what is your goal and interest, because in my sessions, whenever I take career counseling, I include a lot of tests. Now these tests are not aptitude tests. I include interest test, personality test, ability test, and a test to know what are your goals and values. So if you find a counselor who takes all such tests, then it is going to help you. Very quickly, any questions? I'm going to give you just 2 to 3 minutes, then we are going to wind up. Just 2 to 3 minutes, then wind up. I'm going to take 1 or 2 questions if you have any question. Very quickly. Okay, main thing for good communication, again, I will try to share some videos with you on a regular basis for communication. If I have some PDF file and good books, I will share with all of you. And if possible, after this session, we could create a WhatsApp group where we can share knowledge with each other, and then we can share a lot of PDF file. Yes, any one of you can take responsibility to create a WhatsApp group where we can share resources after this chat. That will be very good for all of you for your self-development. Okay, so should we end the session? Just type end. Is anyone want to become scientist from your view? What type of skill they are going to have? Okay, Saranya, I'm going to share with you the PDF which is going to include all of the skills required in different careers. Okay, if you go through that PDF, you will know what skills are required for specifically for scientists. Next is how to improve our personality and speaking. I will share videos. Again, I'm telling you, Manoj, some person take the responsibility to create a WhatsApp group and then add me there. Every one of you be there. I will share with you all the resources for all of you in that WhatsApp group and very good way to get connected. Very quickly, end. Type end if you want to end the session. Type end. Type end. END. Okay. So a very warm thanks to all of you. All of you, very good audience, very interactive audience, very active audience, that all of you are present and you had patience to listen to me and gave me your time. And again, surely if any other there is any other chance for me to serve all of you, because I take seminars on a lot of other topics other than career guidance. It can be relationships, it can be boosting your confidence. There are so many things which I do. So I would be love to club up with all of you. And then now we call it end for this session. Thank you so much and see you all again. Over the moderator.
Okay. Thank you, sir. I would like to ask your contact details, sir, so that students could ask if they have further questions. I would also ask you to share the documents.
Surely.
So
surely.
You could just share it with the participants as well.
Yes,
so
surely.
I would like
surely.
To proceed with a vote of thanks.
Yes,
so,
thank you.
I would like to thank Mr. Gurpreet Singh for accepting our invitation and being our guest today. I think we are the right ones. I would like for taking the session and helping us clear all our queries related to career.
Right. Thank you so much, Richa. And maybe in future, if I club up with you for a session, kindly try that the time is around 90 minutes to 2 hours, because I have had, even today, I had a lot of more things which I needed to share with everyone. So whenever in future, we club up with any other future topic, then give me more time. That would be beneficial for all of the joinees.
Okay, sure, sir.
Okay.
Also, the feedback form would be sent on the chat. The team Evolve welcome you all for the next session that would be happening on Tuesday. Thank you all. Thank you, sir.